had I a golden thread and needle so fine. I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design, of rainbow design. Far over the waters, I'd reach my magic band. So they'd understand.
I know this is supposed to be a music program, but I gotta make a musical instrument. The note is gonna be higher if I make the hole a little bigger. See how that works. Show you what a completed one sounds like, with all eight holes working.
Thank you.
That last was an old Irish tune I was playing, but I have to confess it's an old Israeli-type flute. Well, that is, I learned it from a fellow who came from Israel. Hillel Rabinadov, and he really knows how to play it. He can play it so soft that you can hardly hear it 5 feet away, but it sounds like it's the other side of the mountain. It's very simple. There's nothing to it. You can see right through it. It doesn't have any built-in whistle. You have to make your own whistle. If you want to know how to play it, come up close and you blow about a 30-degree angle, a thin stream of air. Can you whistle? Principle of it. It may take you a couple of weeks before you get the proper embouchure, as the flute players say, and can really get a halfway decent tone, but you can make one in about an hour, and that's what I'm doing. Need a piece of bamboo first, with a straight piece in it, 8 or 10, 12 inches long, 13 inches long. You saw it off. I won't take the whole time up now. It takes about an hour to make it, but I'll shorten the process. Cut off one end, cut the other end right near the joint so that the piece has a slightly smaller hole at one end than the other. You got that? Come up close so you can see her. At one end where you blow in, it's got a medium big size opening there. But the other end, it can be a little bit smaller because you cut it right near the joint. And then you kind of take a jackknife or a piece of sandpaper or a file or something, and you kind of pare away one edge a little bit. This is too small even for the nearest camera to see, but you get an edge eventually that's kind of rounded off on one side, and that's the easy way to blow. If you didn't have that rounded edge, it would come out all rough. Can't do it right. And if you want to make a high-pitched one, you just make it shorter. So on. You actually can make them out of anything. You don't have to make them out of bamboo. I made one for my kid out of an old piece of garden hose. Or an old piece of bathroom shower tubing. What else can I show you? Oh, the idea is that you make the holes one at a time till you get them the right pitch. And make them small first and test it. Now if you want that note to be higher, you just make it a little bit bigger. And the last hole for your thumb up here should be about a quarter of the distance to your mouth. Well, what else can I tell you? I'll show you how one of the little ones sounds. I guess I just made it a little while ago. Oh, if you don't happen to have any fires around, you can use a drill. Ordinary little hand drill. And a rat tail file to make the hole bigger. And to smooth off the inside. You don't want to have any rough things inside it. But frankly, burning's much easier. If you got a gas stove in your house, you just heat up something like a nail punch or, oh, any old piece of metal. Old file or old bolt. Big nail. Well, let's see. Since I learnt this song, this kind of flute making from an Israeli, I ought to play an Israeli tune.
Thank you.
really should sound so lonesome. I played it to a jazz pianist friend of mine once, and he said, you know, that makes you feel just like being a sheep. I do believe that's why these kids learn how to play it. They got all day sitting out under the sky watching a few silly sheep trying to keep them safe. And so naturally they're gonna make some music to pass the time away. Some of those pictures you saw were of Israel. I was there a couple of years back, and I couldn't help kind of feel very close to those people, both the Israeli Jews and the Israeli Arabs, whose ancestors lived there so many, many years ago, as well as now. I thought I'd invite two of Israeli, well, not two Israeli, one American friend of Jewish background who has visited Israel, lived there, and another friend who's an Israeli Arab I met there. He's a poet named Rashid Hussein. Well, he makes a living as a newspaper man. I don't guess there's many poets that make a living at poetry, but his main profession in life is writing poetry. And I've read some of the poems, although I don't understand the Arab language. It's a beautiful language to hear. And so I purposely asked these two friends of mine to come, both at the same time, to join us right here, and we'll swap some songs and stories and poems. My American friend is the famous actor, Theo Bikel, been in dozens of Broadway plays like Sound of Music and so on. I think if you ask Theo what he really enjoyed most of all, it would be, he'd say, well, it's to sit around and swap some stories and songs with people. I've seen Theo come off a job where he's all tired out, and then he starts in singing with some friends, and at 3 o'clock in the morning, he's still going strong. I don't know what songs he's gonna sing today. I don't know what poems Rashid Hussein is going to recite, but they have two very dear friends of mine, and deeply peace-loving people. And that's why I asked him to be here on this Rainbow Crest show. Just a moment, we'll see him. Theo Bikel here, and yep. Rashid Hussein here. What'll we make? Shall we make some music first? No, I want to find out. You told me that you recognized that tune I played on the whistle. What is it?
Anyhow, for me, it's an Arabic music, which was taken by the Israeli. I don't know how, but of course, Israel is found in the Middle East. And the Israeli musicians were influenced by the Arabic music. So I guess they took it.
Absolutely.
Do you know the Hebrew words?
If I'm competent to plead, I'll plead guilty to that. because obviously one always takes from across the valley whatever sounds one hears. It is almost axiomatic that French music, when sung by an Alsatian, sounds a little German. And the Rhinelander sounds a little more French than the Prussian. By the same token, Israel being such a conglomerate of influences, Russian notably when you talk of musical influences, but then comes the Arab shepherd from across the valley, and that sound is so inescapable and so haunting and so lilty. I knew the song as an Israeli song, but of course...
How do the words go?
Mayafim halelot beretz Kenan, tzonenim hem uvehirim.
ורחל רחל שלי מטפסה על ההרים יללת תנים נוגה תחצד מהליל יללת תנים נוגה תחצד מהליל.
It says how beautiful are the nights in Canaan, taken from a biblical text.
And do you know the Arab words to it at all?
I know the Arabic words, but I can't sing them as Bikel can.
Speak them, so I...
Jafra wa yaha rabia, bain al-basatini, dakhli tizra tukla' mitl al-falahini. So it's the same music, really.
You know,
if he could sing it in Arabic, you will see that it's the same thing.
After this program, I will.
And the Arab shepherd, they didn't come. I think that the Israeli came. Oh, the Arab shepherd were there.
Correct.
You know, the same thing has happened in America, North America, Central America, South America, where the Negro slaves and the European people started exchanging music, and especially in Latin America, both of them got music from the Indians there. So that you find a tune from one place getting words from another place, and vice versa.
Afro-Cuban, for one thing, you know, have that whole Caribbean influences is one of them. Anyway, there we are.
Now, Rashid, how many languages do you know?
I know three. One is my mother tongue, Arabic. Hebrew is the other one, and English is the third.
Are Hebrew and Arabic at all similar?
They are very similar because they came from the same source, the Semitic language. Two of them are Semitic languages, and their grammar, a lot of the words are common for the two languages.
To a linguist, they're very similar, because their build, their whole structure of the language is very similar indeed. To an innocent bystander, as it were, who only goes by sounds to his ear, they may not sound as similar as to a linguist, because a linguist knows that, for instance, shalosh, which means numbers three, and talata are the same words, the sh sound and the t sound being interchangeable. But you got a...
Talata is three in Arabic.
In Arabic and Hebrew, almost the numbers and all the parts of the body is the same words.
How about reciting one of your poems in Arabic so I can hear what it sounds like?
Okay.
Okay, that's becoming a universal word.
The name of this poem is What Does a Poet Need in Our Century? This is the first line. It's the name of the poem. ماذا يحتاج الشاعر في القرن العشرين؟ يحتاج لشعب لا يفهم كي ييأس من شعبه ساعتها سنراه يغني لجميع شعوب الأرض. ماذا يحتاج الشاعر في القرن العشرين؟ يحتاج لغل يلثم معصمه كي يتحطم تحطيم الأغلال. يحتاج لسجن يدخله كي يفهم معنى حب السجناء للحرية. في هذا العصر في السجن فقط نلقى أبدا أنقى أشواق الحرية. ماذا يحتاج الشاعر في القرن العشرين؟ يحتاج إلها يقتله ويعود فيخلقه. كي يفهم معنى الخلق يحتاج لقارئ يدرك أن قنابل كل الأرض لا تقدر أن تنشد أغنية حلوة لجنود مشتاقون لأحباب. ماذا يحتاج الشاعر في القرن العشرين حين يشاهد كل الناس يبتلعون سيارات يبتلعون ثلاجات يحتاج لحب لونه حليب أم مرضعة. ماذا يحتاج الشاعر حين يشاهد قتل الناس من أجل الحرية يحتاج لسيف ليس لقلب لكي يحب. ماذا يحتاج الشاعر في القرن العشرين يحتاج لوقت.
Beautiful language.
Mm, very lilty.
What is the meaning in English?
In a very tough English, and you and the other friends, I hope will excuse my poor English. Anyhow, my English is better than your Arabic.
That's right.
It says, in our century, What does a poet need? He needs a people who never listen to his nationalistic songs.
He needs a people who never...
Who never listen to his nationalistic songs.
Nationalistic songs.
Then he will start singing for all the peoples in the world. In our century, what does a poet need? He needs chains to kiss his own wrists.
Chains
to kiss his own wrists.
Is it wrists?
Wrists. In order to learn how to breathe them. He needs a prison to enter in order to understand what exactly the freedom means. In our century, the purest longings for freedom are almost found in the prisons. In our century, what does a poet need? He needs a god to kill and then to recreate.
A god to kill him, to recreate.
So he might know the happiness of creation. He needs a reader who comprehend that the loudest sounding bombs can't sing one sweet slow song for a soldier longing for his love. What does a poet need when he sees people swallowing cars and refrigerators? He needs a love which has the color and the warmth of a nursing mother milk. For loving in our century, what does a poet need? He needs, when seeing people killed, a sword to love with and not only heart. What does a poet need in our century? He needs time.
Oh, good poem.
That's a very tough translation, but you know, I think Robert Frist said that poetry is the thing which you can translate, something like this.
Impossible to translate it.
It's impossible.
And something. The sound of the words is different.
But I like the images. I like the need of the chain, the chains to kiss his wrists in order to be able to break them. Mm-hmm. There we are. Mm. Pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together. No, it's not Arabic.
Well, that's the Old Testament, isn't it?
Yes. How good it is for brothers to dwell together in peace and unity.
I've heard two or three different tunes of that.
Or six or seven. There's a...
הנה מה טוב ומה נעים שבת אחים גם יחד הנה מה טוב ומה נעים שבת אחים גם יחד הנה מה טוב הנה מה טוב la 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 הנה מה טוב הנה מה טוב la 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 הנה מה טוב ומה נעים הנה מה טוב ומה נעים הנה מה טוב ומה נעים הנה מה טוב הנה מה טוב הנה מה טוב הנה מה טוב
that's one and then there's one there's like a march I'm sure you've heard that one it's very martial sounding
I heard one to the tune of John Brown's Body.
That's it. That's the one I meant.
And I even heard.
Oh, God. What will they do now?
Pop music from the United States of America has penetrated the whole world. When I was in Israel, I heard rock and roll on the Lebanon. TV coming, yes. You know, the border can't yes. keep out TV. And so there in Nazareth, yes. where there are many Christian Arabs.
And Muslims. Right, so.
And Muslim yes. Arabs, both. There was a TV in the man's house. It wasn't a big, rich house. It was mud walls and corrugated tin roof. Yes. Very comfortable. And he had a big TV, and there was Lebanon with rock and roll on it.
That's okay, marvelous.
Lebanon and Israel, I think, are a little bit Western countries in the Middle East.
I see.
I mean, the education of the two countries is almost Western.
There's an American university.
Where did you get your education?
At Nazareth in Israel.
In
Nazareth.
In the university?
No, only in the secondary school.
I see. You came to America to study?
I came to America to make a research for the University of Pennsylvania with Dr. Zelig Harris
I see.
In linguistics.
I'm curious to know, besides an occasional melody, are there other music of Arab people that we would be at all familiar with? Well, of course.
Yes, we are. What? Flamenco.
Is flamenco? What?
Yes, absolutely. This was just we talked about before we came here. I think that the flamenco is a mixture of Arabic music and Western music. The Spanish were just more clever than the Arabs, and they developed it and make this cocktail, very nice cocktail of music. You find it also in the Spanish poetry. They had almost the same rhymes as in Arabic, and they took the rhymes and the music and poetry from the Arabs.
In Arab poetry, does the ending of each line rhyme?
In the classic Arab poetry, yes. You can find poems which end mm-hmm. from the beginning to the end with the same letter, even mm-hmm. if you have 200 or 300 lines.
Oh, there. Yeah, that's an alliterative yes. thing, so that every line starts with the same letter of the alphabet. So that, say, you take an M. Yeah. Every single line of some 200 lines of verse all start with M.
Mother went down to the town, making her rounds with a basket. Merry was she when the birds
oh,
sang.
I wish it was so easy, Pete. It's not so easy.
Incidentally, this is we are a little ways after Passover, but looking over the Passover Haggadah that one reads, most of the pieces in there are poems, but they are acrostics. They start with the first letter of the alphabet, with the Aleph, Bet, Gimel, Dalet. So each line starts with the next letter of the alphabet down. And sometimes they get fanciful. They start with the last letter of the alphabet and go back to the Aleph.
Okay. How about the rhyme scheme which people who know English know through Fitzgerald's translation, Omar Khayyam?
Yes.
They're the first and second line rhymed with the fourth.
Yes, it's also used in Arabic.
And the third is not rhymed with anything.
Omar Khayyam wrote in Persian, not in Arabic.
Are they similar, though?
The rhymes, yes, they are similar. But you can find it in the poetry of the Middle Ages. I mean, in the Arabic poetry of the Middle Ages, they wrote the same thing, like Omar Khayyam. something similar in the same way. But today you will find exactly all these kinds of modern poetry without rhyme, without the same end.
We ought to take a break now. What, let's sing a song before we do.
All right.
You have a whistle there too?
Oh, have a. I was trying to see whether I could make it. I don't know if I still can.
I never will. Let's come back in a few seconds, and then we'll have some more songs. Okay. Tzena, 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 hamra, terena, chayalim, bamashava. Alna, 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 chavera, mi bencha. Tzena, tzena, amrom torena, chayalim b'moshava. Alna, 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 tichavena mibenha, yilish tzava. Tzena, tzena, amrom torena, chayalim b'moshava.
Tzena, 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 tzena.
Ha! That is one song that always ends with a bang.
Your Hebrew is wonderful.
Ah, no.
I should have told you beforehand. It embarrasses him when you give him compliments. Okay.
No, but you know, I've sung that in all kinds of countries, and I get audiences singing with me, or at least clapping their hands, and I tell them, at least you can say tzena, 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 tzena. Boom!
You know, audiences always are willing to sing along if you just infuse them with the right amount, and you always do, with the right amount of insouciance, I guess is the word, to you, chutzpah. So they feel that they can, they're allowed to, and that their wives will not go home and then berate them later that they had to sing at all costs. And clap, anybody can sing la 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 to begin with.
Well, there are a lot of songs from that whole part of the world, aren't there, which have a simple chorus which goes over and over again. I've seen movies of Arab songs where
yes.
A simple refrain is going over and over, and it builds up and gets more exciting as it goes over and over.
Yes, it's
5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes.
That's right. In Arabic, you can have songs which, how do you say, mitmashchim.
They draw themselves out.
They draw themselves out for 1 or 2 hours even.
You know why? Because
yes.
There's a lot of time.
There is a lot of time, but not today.
I know, but you see, when the Arab songs were written,
yes.
People would sit with a string of beads and contemplate the world, and the beads, there's a marvelous thing about beads. It's a circle. You never come to the end of them. So you go and go and go.
Well, I'm firmly convinced that the more labor-saving machinery is invented, somehow the less time we have. We have time for another poem. Would
yes.
you?
Would you like the Hebrew one?
You write poems
in Hebrew
also?
I'm trying, you see. I don't know if they are successful.
Well,
but here my friend can say, I
right.
don't know.
You read it and you translate it, mm-hmm.
Shir ala tzel. Hu nulad blondini, vi nuladti shahor. Lo hayu bigde meshi, vidi bigde kutna. Aval davar ihad tamid, haya lishnenu mishutaf. הצבע של הצל, הצבע של הצל שלו וצבע אצלי היה תמיד אותו דבר. והזדקנו יחד, הוא בארמונותיו, ואני עם עוניי ודלותי בכוך. אבל דבר אחד סירב להזדקן, והוא נשאר לשנינו משותף. הצבע של הצל. הצבע של הצל שלו וצבע אצלי, כמו בילדותינו, נשאר אותו דבר. וגם חלינו יחד, ולא היה לי רופא, ולא היו רופאים, אבל אתמול הוא מת. אולם דבר אחד סירב למות, והוא נשאר לשנינו משותף, הצבע של הצל, צל קברו המת, וצל גופי החי, צבע צל המוות והחיים, נשאר אותו דבר.
Beautiful word. I must try and translate this. Missy. He was born blonde-haired, and I black. He had silken clothes, and I clothes made of it, simpler kind. But one thing we had in common, the color of our shadow. The color of his shadow, the color of mine, it was always the same. We aged together, he in his palace and I in my hut. But one thing refused to age, the one thing we had in common, the color of the shadow of his and of mine, as in our youth, so it remained in our old age. And we fell sick together, and he had a doctor, and he had many doctors, but yesterday he died. One thing refused to die, the one thing we had in common, the color of the shadow, the color of the grave of a dead man, and the color of my live body.
The color of the shadow of the grave and the color of my alive
of my live body. Yes. Remained
the same, the color of life. The color of the shadow of life and death remained the same.
Nice.
Very
good
poem.
Nice.
What different kinds of subjects do you have for your poems? I know there must be, there are always love poems,
yes,
in different languages.
Of course.
And are there humorous poems that
are... There are humorous poems too. If you mean me, I don't know if you mean this. But in the Arabic poetry, you almost find all the subjects which you find in any other poetry in the world. The difference is that in Arabic, for instance, you will find that the majority or the large part of the Arabic poetry is almost political.
Well, in the recent years, so much poetry has been political poetry?
Yes, in the recent years and in the past years. Even 1,000 years ago, the Arab poet was considered to be as the journalist is today. He just registered all what happened in poems.
I have heard an old legend, have you ever heard it? That in the ancient days, if a king put a poet on his payroll, they called it cutting off the tongue of the poet. Because once he was on the payroll...
I understood one thing, that the tongue of the poet may be cut. But I didn't understand the first part.
The payroll.
When the king paid him.
Paid him, yes.
He hires...
He cuts his tongue, no.
No, in effect. You see, supposing there's a poet that is not paid by the king, he's free to make up rhymes, perhaps making fun of the king.
Yes.
Or satirizing him.
Yes.
But if the king hires the poet, says, now you be a member of my court,
yes,
and I'll give you lots of money,
yes,
now write poetry.
Yes.
In effect, he has cut off the tongue of the poet because the poet will no longer write satires about the king.
In this case, you are right. But anyhow, I think that a lot of the Arabic poetry 1,000 years ago, in the time of the caliphs and before that, was written in the palaces of the caliphs and the kings.
Subsidized, in fact. by the
king. Yes, they lived there. They were subsidized. But some of them, even living in the palace of the king, they made fun of him. And he just loved. Some of them were not, they didn't have a sense of humor, some of these kings, so they killed the poet.
Oh, dangerous.
I heard that.
We have time for a couple more songs, Theo.
I thought of something. You know, we've sung only Israeli and related songs practically so far. And I thought of a song. See, it suddenly occurred to me. It's a. Maybe you'd like to swing along on this. It's a guajira, one of the many guajiras. It says, we have. They go to work, you see, before sunrise. And they say, the sun will come up soon and the rays will be dancing and singing. And although our life, our lot, the lot of a cart driver is a sad one, still we have each other in our song.
Viva Juan. Por ello, vamos a cantar. Ahora.
Se acerca la madrugada, los rayos están cantando, compadre tan ya luciendo. Que se acerca la alborada, ay.
Adentro.
Luciendo que se acerca la alborada. Carretero, y ando por eso que allá verá, sabiendo que su vida es un destierro, se alegran con sus cantares.
La última.
Vamos.
We got so interested talking with each other, we only have time for about a song and a half more. Here be. And I think we'll dedicate it to all the children, all the Jewish children, all the Arab children, all the children everywhere, France, Germany, China, Japan, Paraguay, where that last song came from. How did they get a guajira down in Paraguay?
because I suppose that those people who came from the region of that this is supposed to come from, in Venezuela, they spread all over. When there's a famine, they go...
There's a little bit of Spanish flamenco in there.
That, I think, is predetermined by the shape of a guitar, because it can make those sounds best.
Do you know a children's rhyme?
Yes, I know one.
Well, see if you can recite a children's rhyme, because since this song is for all the children...
Yes. Okay. في أوضتي في صندوق وفي الصندوق كلسوني والصندوق بده مفتاح والمفتاح عند الحداد والحداد بده بيضة والبيضة عند الجاجي والجاجي بدها علفي والعلفي عند الفلاح والفلاح بده مطرة والمطرة عند الغيمي والغيمي بدها بحرة والبحرة بدها سباح والسباح بده كلسون وكلسوني في الصندوق والصندوق بده مفتاح والمفتاح عند الحداد and
What do the words mean?
It's a boy who wants to swim. But he says, in my room, there is a box. And in the box is my swimming suit. The box needs a key. But the key is with the key maker. And the key maker wants eggs. We were used to buy with eggs that time. Wants eggs, and the eggs are with the hen, and the hen wants corn, and the corn is with the peasant, and the peasant wants rain, and the rain is with the cloud, and the cloud wants the lake, needs the lake, and the lake needs the swimmer. But my swimming suit is in the box, and the box needs a key, and the key is with the key maker. And it goes around and around and around.
Last night I had the strangest dream I never dreamed before. I dreamed the world had all agreed to put an end to war. I dreamed I saw a mighty room. The room was full of men, and the paper they were signing said they'd never fight again. And when the paper was all signed and a million copies made, and bow their heads and grateful prayers were prayed. And the people in the streets below were dancing round and round, and swords and guns and uniforms were scattered on the ground.
Last night I had the strangest dream.
I never dreamed before.
I dreamed the world had all agreed.
I dreamed the world had all agreed to put an end to war. Oh, had I a golden thread and needle so fine, I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design, of rainbow design. In it I'd weave the bravery of women given giving birth. In it I'd weave the innocence of children over all the earth, children of all earth. Far over the waters I'd reach my magic band. Every city, through every single land, through every land. Sure, my brothers and my sisters, my reign.